macular degeneration, glaucoma, and diabetic retinopathy are some of the leading causes of blindness amongst North Americans and also all over the world. So one of the most leading causes of severe vision loss in the world is diabetic retinopathy. So that's changes to the blood vessels at the back of the eye. Often it's where your blood vessels leak and you have a sort of loss of the integrity of your retina. So this will often lead to very severe losses in your vision as well. Well, sometimes for many patients, they'll come in for an eye exam and you may not necessarily in the early stages have any signs or symptoms. So the important factor with diabetic retinopathy is treating it in its early stages. If we just let it go, it's gonna cause sort of permanent losses in vision that cannot be reversed. So that is sort of the main concern with diabetic retinopathy. And then in cases where you do have those leaky blood vessels, we will do or send you for laser treatment. So that laser treatment is gonna seal off those leaky blood vessels. But again, this treatment is most effective in the early stages. And the more that diabetes progresses, and the more the retinopathy continues, the less likely we'd be able to treat it in any way. So it is important. Again, diabetics should be screened annually. So if somebody has diabetes, coming in for a regular eye exam, it should be at least once a year. So the macula is the central most part of our vision. It's where, it's the central part of our retina responsible for us seeing detail, reading, recognizing faces. And when that starts to get damaged, that's when we call it macular degeneration. There's two forms of macular degeneration. One is the wet form and the other is the dry. Now the difference is that the dry form is slowly progressing and patients may not notice the symptoms of that as quickly as they would the wet form. The wet form usually progresses quite rapidly and those patients will pick up on those symptoms a little bit sooner. But the reason why it's so important to have this screened for or tested for regularly is, again, the symptoms or signs may not be there at the early stages. And again, macular degeneration is also one of those diseases that cannot be treated. If there is damage to your macula, we can only try to prevent it from getting worse, but we can't treat what's already been lost. So again, coming in for a regular eye exam is going to help us to diagnose and start to prevent progression of the eye disease. Also UV protection. UV damage is one of the leading causes of macular degeneration. So if you can do something as simple as just throwing on a good pair of sunglasses, even from a young age to the elderly, it's so important. You can really prevent those changes from happening. So glaucoma is thought to be caused by increased pressure in the eye. And that increased pressure affects the nerves that actually communicate with our brain. And that pressure goes up due to the fluid that circulates throughout our eye. When that pressure goes up and it damages those nerve fibers, it causes a loss of vision. So what people here are gonna experience is usually a loss of their peripheral vision. And if you think about that, with both eyes open together, we often don't really always notice how far peripheral vision goes. So it's very easy to not notice that you have a loss of peripheral vision. So glaucoma progresses very slowly in most cases. And if this is the case, then a patient may not even know that they have it. We use something called an OCT, optical coherence tomography. And what this does is it performs several little scans that actually show us the different layers of the retina. And sometimes it'll, if we want to just see what the optic nerve looks like, it'll show us any damage that's occurring in those layers or bundle fibers as well. So it's a great tool in diagnosing changes to your optic nerve and preventing the glaucoma disease from progressing. Because again, it is one of those diseases that is, preventable, but once you have damage, that damage is irreversible. Lots of these leading causes of vision loss can happen without any signs or symptoms. So you may not be noticing it, but you might be affected by it. And the best way to actually find out is to see your eye care specialist.